Well, it started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone. And the sun went down as it crossed the hill. And the town lit up.
We've just arrived at Nairobi Airport.
Say hello.
Hi.
We're really tired. That's flight number 2, and it is, I don't even know what time it is in the morning.
It's Andy. Hi, say hi.
Hi.
I'm looking at the camera.
Here's everyone else. Say hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
May not return. And the rocks might melt. And the seed may burn. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing.
All right, we're on the bus now from Kilimanjaro. I mean, International Airport, and yeah, on our way to
Moshi.
Some say life will beat you down and break your heart, steal your crown. So I've started out for God knows where. I guess I'll know when I get there. I'm learning to fly around the clouds. But what goes up must come down.
Say hi, Liske.
Hello.
Liske doing the flag.
Yep, getting there.
And Bradley doing some hard work on Kilimanjaro. Yeah.
I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
This is the night before we got diarrhea.
I'm learning to fly.
Morning all. It's morning of day one. We've just had our last shower.
Here's Brad. Say hi.
I've had my last hair wash for the next 7 days. We're about to go have breakfast and then do our final pack. And then we're off. Can you believe it? Bye.
I'm learning to fly.
Trail, the Rongai route up Kilimanjaro. We arrived there in that van to find all of these porters here. So we've just eaten a fat carbo loaded lunch, and to prove that I'm here too, we're almost ready to get on our way. Dad, say hello.
Hi, Brad. I mean, hi, everybody.
Every day you wake up, I hope it's
So this is Simba Camp. We arrived here about 1.5-2 hours ago. It's now 6 o'clock. All the porters and all of that are making our food and sorting everything out. When we arrived, they were still busy with our tents, but now they have finished. And we've all sort of changed and got a bit cleaner. It was a really dusty day. Everywhere was just dust. And quite a ascent, but actually not bad. We all feeling quite good still. No one's sick yet. And so now we're here just in the tent about to have some nice coffee, and they've given us popcorn and biscuits. When I hold your small body close to mine, I feel weak and strong at the same time. Soak your ears to give you wings to fly. Show you stars to guide your ship by. So it's morning, day two. I've just woken up. It's kind of cold, as you can see. Slept okay-ish. It's quite hard. Sleeping bag is huge, and obviously no pillow. And another thing is needing to wee like every 5 minutes. And so while Brad and I can't sink, are needing to wee. So he wees and I wee, and he wees and I wee. So that was kind of hard. I'm the only one up now. Everyone else is asleep, I think. So they're just busy preparing breakfast and that. And then, they wake us up at 6:30. I have no idea what the time is now. And then we've got half an hour to get dressed and pack. And then while we go eat, we take our water bottles to them for them to fill. And then between 7 and 8 they will pack up our tents and get ready so that we leave by latest 8:30. It's a beautiful morning, it's crystal clear. We're above the cloud lines, which is amazing. There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do. But places we got to be, we'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We've done about 12 kilometers, I think, today, and we've gone up a lot in elevation. I must say every breath I take is quite something, but feeling really good. So everywhere we go, they set up a portaloo, And I'm telling you, if ever there was a loo with a view, it is this one. I mean, it's incredible. So the door's facing the other side, and I'm just gonna go in front of it. But if you have a look here, you can see that in the distance. We're very high. Absolutely beautiful though. The porters are of another species, I'm telling you, they are amazing. They just run past you with all our billion kilos of weight on their back and neck. It's absolutely incredible. Anyway, as you can see, that's Brad and my tent there. And those two buckets there, it's nice hot water they come and give us. So I need to go wash because it feels like it's about minus 10 right now. It's freezing. So I want to get that water while it's still hot. Check in again. Bye. How beautiful is that? That's Mwenzi. Huge, absolutely beautiful. And then, what we're heading for is that Kilimanjaro. With the fire and the steel, the general told them.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Andre! Happy birthday to you!
Hooray!
Mud and sweat. So it's below zero tonight. We're in our tent. Say hi, Brad.
Hello.
We're on a slope sort of again, but we're using our duffel bags as pillows. Morning of day 3. Slept like a baby last night. Much warmer. Well, it was cold outside, but I was much warmer, more organized last night. It's an absolutely beautiful morning. Way above the clouds. So today we are going to be hiking for about 6 hours, I think. Yep. Going up quite a lot,
650 meters,
but we should arrive at our next camp at lunchtime, and that's where we will be for 2 nights, because tomorrow we'll be doing an acclimatization hike. So we'll go up, we'll come down, but for now apparently this hike is okay, but we'll see how it goes.
Under this altitude, 650 meters is quite hectic. Scouts rode out to spy the land. Even as the realm's soldiers lay resting, MacGyver's forces were soon at hand. And by the evening, the vultures were wheeling above.
We've arrived at our next camp, which is the Mwenzi Tarn Hut. We're over 4,000 meters in elevation. Today's walk was quite a lot of uphill, but it was good. Feeling quite good, I must say. No one seems to be very sick or having any problems yet. Yeah, this is where we are for two nights now, tomorrow. That's the like ranger's hut, all the cairns up there in the distance. And there you get to see, these are the hands of today. They look absolutely disgusting and I haven't even started setting my tent up. And you can see we're going into the clouds again. These are tents here. And I'll pull to New York. How lucky are we? We get a nice bucket of warm water. You can see the dust though you're working in. All my toiletries, my nice towel. Let me get off all this dusty clothing, get nice and fresh and clean and ready for a nice nap, I think. Look at this view. Absolutely amazing. Just too cold. I mean, I don't even think I know what warm toes even mean. Yeah, anyway, bye. Lala salama. It is so cold that I'm standing inside our food tent doing this video, because at least in here there's a little bit of warmth. When the sun comes up it's much better, but last night was ridiculously cold. I didn't really sleep. Brad slept like a bomb, so tonight we're joining our sleeping bags. But I'm gonna go show you how cold it was. So the water we get every morning to wash, I'm gonna go show you what it looks like this morning. Beautiful day. Say hi, Brad.
Hi, man.
Hello.
Hi, Andy.
I slept for about 7 hours.
That's our water.
from last night. And that's basically how my body feels. So today we're just doing an acclimatization hike. Apparently, we're just going to walk for about an hour and go up about 200 meters. And then we'll come down quick. And that's it for the day. Thank goodness. So I really didn't sleep last night, so I want to try this afternoon to sleep. Anyway, they've just delivered our morning water, and before it turns to ice, I'm gonna go brush my teeth. Yay! Even the toothpaste this morning is like sticky, solid, not really proper. Anyway,
if bye. You have your doubts, just believe, yeah. And through all this questioning that slapped you in the face, oh my darling, embrace it, embrace it.
On s'amuse, on parle beaucoup, mais que cela veut dire et qu'on aide à la pousse et qu'on parle amour, bien sûr. Je t'adore, je te parle la vérité, non t'en fais, on s'amuse. Mais ce live et ce soir, sois à l'aise. Tonight.
Tonight.
So quickly, there's no hope in you for me. No corner you could squeeze me, but I got all the time for you, love. The space between the tears we cry, the laughter keeps us coming back for more. The space between the wicked lies we tell and hope to keep safe from the pain. But will I hold you again? These fickle, fuddled words confuse me. Like, will it rain today? Waste the hours with talking. These twisted games we're playing. We're strange allies with warring hearts.
So we are at the end of day four. Hey Brad.
Mm-hmm.
End of day four. We're still at the Mwenzi Tarn Hut. We did an acclimatization hike today, so we just went straight up, but it wasn't that far. When we got to the top, there was the view of Kili, which was kind of terrifying. It looks very daunting. And this time, tomorrow night, it'll almost be time to go. Then we came down for the rest of the day. It was just rest time. By the time we got back to our camp, two more groups had arrived. So it's really busy here tonight. It's quite noisy, so very grateful for earplugs. And we're hoping tonight to actually sleep because last night was not fun. Other than that, I think we're all doing pretty well. Our guide says we're doing well. He hasn't needed to check any of our oxygen levels yet, which is always a good thing. And yeah, tomorrow we're off to Kibo Hut, which is Kili's base camp. Yeah, we'll get there and hopefully summit the next morning. So good night for now. Just to add, it is freezing. I am at the moment wearing my thermals and then my fleece and then another fleece and then my down jacket and then my big rain jacket thing, and I could still feel the cold. Had a towel outside drying, and it's only been there for the evening. I mean, it's early still. I think it's only like 8 or past 8. And I just brought the towel in, and it's full of icicles. Everyone, it's day 5. That's my breakfast. Doesn't that look nice? So it was still really cold last night, but slept a little bit better. Show you some morning life. So in the morning we put all our water bottles out and they go and fill them, and then we put our bags here and they take them away, and then they start demolishing our tent. As you can see that gap there, it's Brad and my tent. We always finished first. So yeah, tent's gone. Everyone busy everywhere. Fanning weather again today. And today we head to Kibo, which is base camp for Kilimanjaro. And we will start our summit tonight at 11 o'clock. We're aiming to leave so that we can get there at sunrise. Our guide says, from what he's gathered so far in our group, will probably take about 6 to 7 hours to get to summit, which is pretty exciting. Hi Brad, how are you feeling today?
Pretty good.
Better? How are those tingly fingers?
Pretty damn tingly.
Alright, Brad's got tingly fingers from his diamond.
Oh, it's only you that remains with me, clear as the light of day.
Oh, si es, oh, si es, si so figa we baba no ma. Oh, si es, oh, si es, si a kuja lo.
Looks up to his father for a sign or an approving eye. Oh, it's funny how those ones so close are now gone still so affect our lives.
Oh, si es,
I'm coming.
Oh, si es,
I'll be coming.
Sin so figa where my mind or mine.
You know the tide is turning.
Oh, si es, oh, si es,
you know the tide is turning.
Si,
at Kibo Hut, which is base camp for Kilimanjaro. Oh my word, tonight we are leaving and we're going up that path over there. Yo, today's hike was hard. It felt like it never ended. We came from, oh, you can't see us behind that mountain, but Everything's just so sparse and tiring, and things look close, but they are so far away. So our little camp right here, we've all just had to sign in, feeling a little worse for wear, but actually I'm so excited. I almost can't wait for tonight. But first it's lunch, and then we've got to get ready, get all our stuff ready, and then we have an early supper, and then we try to go to sleep before we wake up. But man, we are on top of the world. Yes, this is like so exciting. Oh.
Wednesday morning, and we're headed up to Uhuru Peak from Kibo Huts at the bottom of the Kibo volcano, which is the highest volcano in Kilimanjaro National Park, Kilimanjaro, and we have to hike up 5 hours now to get to Gilman's Point, and then we have to hike up another hour to get to Stella Point, and then another 45 minutes to get to Uhuru Peak, which is the highest point. And now we're going up 1,200 meters from 4,720 meters. So you can imagine we're all pretty much apprehensive right now.
Seasons keep on turning. Sometimes hard to keep up the fight.
So we made it to Gilman's Point, and then to Stella Point.
I can see a new tomorrow. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Strange freedom. Only free to choose my chains. So hard not to weaken. Just give up and walk away. I will climb the ancient mountain. I will find the last flicker of the light. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro.
Oh yeah.
I can see a new tomorrow. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I cast away all my sorrow. Oh, I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. It fills me right down to the marrow. Oh, I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I can see a new tomorrow.
And we're busy coming back from it, but look at this view from a Wednesday. It's so beautiful. We had the best weather, and check the slope that we went up this morning, and busy coming down, but this view, magical. Day 6 today, and we're actually already leaving what's it called? Kibo Hut. We summited all of us last night, some with a little more help beautiful view that we're walking in at the moment. Absolutely magical. And we're all really happy because we're leaving. It was a really rough night. And
it was quite traumatic.
The altitude sickness and all of that was a lot worse. So now, on the day you summit this like monster mountain, they make you walk another 10Ks to your next campsite. And that's where we're staying tonight. And then we've got one more long hike tomorrow. And then we are finished. And there's Brad and Kennedy. Kennedy was my hero for the night. He took my bags and sorted me out and got me down the hill and blah, 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 blah. The guides are absolutely fantastic.
Yeah,
they really, really know what they're doing. And they're very supportive. And they'll give up anything that they have to make you comfortable, including their gloves, their scarves, their bags, their headlights, everything. So it's very sweet. Anyway, enjoy the last few of Kili. Bye.
And where find you lover? Go away somewhere all bright and new. I have seen no other who compares. Flowers, you belong in a boat out at sea. You belong with your love on your arm.
Good morning, everyone. It's our final day. Today we go down about 20 kilometers and we're doing in about 7 hours. So we'll be back at the hotel this afternoon. We're all feeling much better after a good night's sleep. Actually rained a little bit last night, which was really nice because it made the temperature not so freezing. And we actually woke up to this view, which I'm going to show you now, of Kili with some snow on it. Check it out. So I'm glad we're not going up Kili like that. It must be so cold. And even Mawenzi over here has got some snow on it, which is amazing. We've just had breakfast and we're about to leave Horomba Huts. I must say, I'm looking forward to getting back to the hotel. Have a nice shower. My hair is disgusting. I feel disgusting. Our hands are all sore and burned and tired, but I think it's going to be quite a nice hike today because it's through the forest. It'll be quite pretty. And the weather is stunning as always. Look at this view. Going all the way down there. We'll be camping. And these are the Horombo huts up there. Everyone's got slight sore throats and coughing and that, but I think after that freezing hike through the night with minimal rest to Kili, not surprised we're all feeling like that. But we all made it, and that's really all that counts. Okay, bye!
stars across the heavens. There's a whispering song of the wind in the grass. There's a rolling thunder across the savannah. A hope and a dream at the edge of the sky. And your life is a story like the wind. Your life is a story like the wind.
I'm searching for the spirit of the great heart.
Thank you.